Hello everyone, welcome to episode 146 of Mario Kart Wii Races, and I am your narrator and host, Ninetales Commander. Now, I'm racing against another hack from the brilliant Dr. Logi, who is an excellent hacker by the way, and if you haven't checked him out yet, then we're not going to bother saying again, because I said so in the last video. But, this time racing as Pinata? Is his name? I can't remember his name, to be honest. I don't care about his name really, but I saw him, I saw him that you could play as him, and I thought, you know what, this guy looks pretty cool actually, so I'm going to race as him. Or her actually, got to think of it, because he's wearing a skirt, I suppose, so does that mean he's a girl actually? Oh, I don't know. Well, leave your thoughts in the comments if you want. And what do you know, I just got myself another Bullseye counter. I'm not going to bother showing a replay, because I'm sure you guys don't need it. And believe it or not, in this video, there's actually going to be another mini feature added, because I'm sure you guys may have noticed, over the past couple of videos of this show, the quality and the presentation has changed a bit because I'm using my new editor. And one feature that I'm able to add in now, that I decided to throw in, was actually kind of like a way for people to understand exactly where the bullseye counters take place. Because, you see, I've had a couple of times in the comments previously where people have said, where was the bullseye counter for so-and-so? Where did that one count for? So what I'm going to do is, there's going to be, every time there's a bullseye counter that wasn't clear, if it was like I placed a fake box or a banana or something, and there was quite a time gap in between the two, I will show a brief replay of when it was I exactly showed the trap. And in addition, I also display the times as well, the times of the video where it happened, so you guys will know exactly where the bullseye counter was for, etc, etc, basically. And I can't believe I did that. That was so stupid of me. But, you know, you'll see the feature in action soon enough. There is a little bit of a fun part to it as well that you might like. It's nothing major, but I personally think you're going to like it. So, and it's sort of a feature character, but the feature character that it's for is actually kind of already here, believe it or not. And, you know, and you could argue that it would be Frank West that does the role, but I decided, you know what, no, I'm going to use someone else. I'm going to have somebody else do this role. So it's technically they're going to be the first counter and feature character. Whatever. Well, I guess I'm speeding into it a bit too much. So, anyway, now, as always, I'm going to go into a topic of discussion, as always, because I like to do that every single time. And, whoa, that was pretty wild. I got thunderbolted and I got smacked by a turtle. What's that? Double impact, you could say. But today's topic of discussion is actually about the Custom Track Worldwide. Now, Custom Track Worldwide has been released a good while now. I think it's been over a year? And it's something that's actually worth checking out. Watch this. Whoa, get a rewind. Damn, that was pretty close. Anyway, thanks for the replay, Frank. Now, the part that really bothers me a bit about the Custom Track Worldwide is the fact that Nintendo don't seem to care about it. I mean, they must know about it due to the fact that, well, we are kind of using their servers and we're using their areas. And they are actually well within their rights to stop it us if they wanted to. And I wouldn't blame them if they did, even though it would be a little bit dumb because we're technically making their game better, which probably might be the reason why they haven't bothered anything about it. Because Nintendo only usually seem to go for stuff like that when it's actually cheating, and technically Custom Track Worldwide isn't really cheating really when you think about it. It's just making a game have more options really. So maybe that's why Nintendo have not bothered with anything about it, because we're not really interfering with their business practices. If anything, in a way, you could argue that we are actually helping them. You know, because we're technically making their game better than it already is, and we are using their engine, so the credit does still go to Nintendo, because we're making the characters and we're making the stages, and we haven't even figured out how to do the sound effects yet. Don't know if we ever will, and whoa, Daisy went for a little while there without a red shell. But Custom Track Worldwide, yeah, the reason it hasn't happened yet is because of the fact that Custom Track Worldwide is very vast. If you want... Yeah, I almost think to a degree that maybe it's been a little bit overdone, because I think there's easily over 150 tracks on Custom Track Worldwide, and that's not counting the default tracks on the actual game itself. Yes, that's right, there has been that many courses made, and I personally do think It may have been a little bit overdone. If it had been me, I'd have kept it at say around 100 courses, because anything more just feels like you're adding in too much, if you know what I mean. It's not so bad with characters, because with characters, you know, you can get used to them and you can train with them and it gives you a big variety, but when you've got that many courses to learn, I just think it's more of a pain, and you know, and I would much prefer it if, instead of focusing on custom tracks all the time, I would prefer it if people could make more character hacks more often. Obviously, I'm not telling people to do this, it's just my personal preference, and trust me, some of the courses I have seen made by users are amazing. They are even better than the actual designs Nintendo have given us. You know, that's how impressive some of them really are. But I personally do think that we've come to the point now where we haven't got to focus on courses anymore. I think we've gotten enough custom courses. Now, it could be that character hacking is a lot harder than doing custom courses, which I can definitely understand, because I've seen some of the conversations people have had with making a customized character, and some of the stuff they've talked about has been like Spanish to me, or Greek or whatever, because it just doesn't make sense to me in the slightest. And I have sometimes thought about trying to take this task up, but I just haven't got the time for it. Plus, I don't think I need to, because, you know, even though I do wish there was more people out there that would become character hackers, on the other hand, I can say that we do have a decent supply as it is. Plus, most of the characters I wanted are already made, and a lot of the characters I want are already being made, and a lot of the characters, the only real character that I think I would like to see on this that probably can't be done is Lightning Farron, obviously, because that's like a character I really admire, you know, which you probably have known, realized by now. But one thing I can say is Lightning Farron is a character I would like to see be able to be raced as, but I don't think it's possible to do, because the game that she's from, you know, is PS3 graphics. Yeah, I did say that maybe the models from, you know, Dissidia could work, but again, hard to say, because I don't understand how it all works. But then again, one argument I do have is, according to the research I've been told, the character Wreck-It Ralph, that is a hack available to be used on this, is a customized hack. It wasn't ported from any game, it was completely made off of, from scratch, which is probably why it was quite hard to make. But one thing I can say is, you know, if they can do Wreck-It Ralph, who's to say they can't just make a Lightning Farron from base? You know, if anybody here is watching this and they understand how all of this works, then, you know, and they understand how to make customized characters, then what's keeping anyone from making a Lightning Farron hack, or any other character for that matter? Because I've seen loads of requests. I've seen people request Rainbow Dash, I've seen people request other characters, Final Fantasy VII characters, and I know we've got Cloud on these videos, but nevertheless, it still works. And here you go, here is your new feature. Counters right here, and here is where I place the fake box. Yes, and as you can see, I even placed the times and everything for you. And oh yes, no problem, dude. Thank you, Shuma. I appreciate that very much. I decided to say make a little screen where Shuma shows exactly where the thing was placed for his counter. I was gonna say use Frank, but then I thought, you know what? It's Shuma's counter. Let him do the telling forward for a change. So I hope you guys like that. I personally think that's a pretty neat feature, and it even gives the times everything to when it happened. So, you know, I hope you guys like that. But anyway, now, you know, that's basically what I'm trying to say here. You know, when you look at the character modding and everything that has been hacked and the whole Wreck-It Ralph incident, then why is it, you know, they can make that, but they can't seem to make a Lightning Farron? You know, who's to say that they can't do a Lightning Farron from scratch? I mean, obviously there's probably things I don't understand and everything I don't know. So, you know, it could just be that she's too hard to make or something, or, you know, or the animation is all off. But nevertheless, I do think it would still be worth discussing over. But anyway, that's what I'm going to talk about. Now, back to Custom Track Worldwide. You know, it is definitely awesome, but I think at this point, you know, it's been pushed to the point. If it was me, and, you know, I would say the guys that are in charge of, you know, Custom Track Worldwide and everything, I would probably say that either cut some tracks off that you don't feel is needed, that may be outclassed by other tracks, or, you know, stop adding on more tracks, you know, in all honesty. Now, I would say maybe do one more boost, but again, that would be a tad hypocritical to what I said earlier. But I just think to the point now where Custom Track Worldwide, it's long, it's fast, and it is awesome how there's a lot of tracks from previous Mario Kart games on there, you know, which is pretty cool to be honest. But I can't say that, you know, that's basically it, you know. I think it's been pushed to the point now where we don't need to focus on it anymore. You know, maybe throw in the odd new track every now and again, maybe say add on 10 new tracks per update, which won't be too bad because then it'll be on a much less, you know, plethora of tracks at once, because there's a lot of times where when there's an update available and there's new tracks to be added, everything has just gone, you know, there's been loads of new tracks added. Now, a lot of people could say that's a good thing, but I personally do say that it might be a little bit too many at once, you know, because, you know, and oh, another Bowser encounter. That was pretty well aimed, actually, you know, if I do say so myself. But in all honesty, I just think that Custom Track Worldwide, it's a great mode, and my huge respects go to the people that made it. I honestly can't get my head around exactly how they made it happen, because, you know, it literally makes use of Nintendo servers, and it literally, you know, brings everyone in the world on Custom Track Worldwide together, and I just think that's amazing. Yeah, so you know, it's definitely a very notable achievement, and it definitely has given this game the credit it deserves. But I think now your achievement has been lived. I think the achievement has been, it's achieved, it's brilliant, it's fantastic. But I think at the point now where, you know, I think we just don't need any new tracks, if you know what I mean. Because I think the main issue I'm saying we need new, don't need new tracks is, if you've got somebody that's getting into Custom Track Worldwide and they suddenly see all these over 200 tracks available to them, they're going to be like, oh my days, I've got to learn all these tracks. And they're like, oh no, stop this, I ain't doing this. And they just go back to all your regular modes, which is terrible, because, you know, that means that all your hard work has gone to waste because people just can't bother to learn that many stages at once. I personally don't let that discourage me, you know, if a game has more stages and the more fun it is. But on the other hand, I just feel as though Custom Track Worldwide has had enough, if you know what I mean. Yeah, I know some of the stuff I'm saying in this video may seem a little bit hypocritical to other stuff I'm saying, but, you know, understand when I say, you know, there is, it's okay to have a good selection, but it's, I think it's not okay to keep adding on loads of new tracks over and over again, if you guys know what I mean exactly. But expect Custom Track Worldwide sometime soon, hopefully. I do plan to try and get into it, and hopefully do more coverage of those, because it will make this series a lot more entertaining, at least in my opinion. But anyway, I've talked for a long time now, so I'm going to go now. Leave your thoughts in the comments below if you want to give your thoughts on Custom Track Worldwide if you play on it. See you guys next time. Peace out.